In today's video, we're going to be having a look at 5 new features that I'd love to see be added to Home Assistant in 2023. Check it out. What's going on, guys? I hope you're all doing well. Last year, I did a very similar video to this where I ran through a bunch of features that I'd love to see added. And some of them were a bit wild and out there, and some of them actually did get added. And if you are interested in checking out that video, you'll find a link to it in the description below. So let's jump straight into it then with my first feature. And this one is one that is definitely actually gonna be coming this year, I think.
Oh, drag and drop. Yes, it's coming.
Yeah, it is.
Yes.
Now, it's been teased a couple of times by Home Assistant, and if you were eagle-eyed, you will have seen it in a couple of videos that they've posted out. But this feature is drag and drop. Over the last couple of years, we've seen a few different attempts and implementations of drag and drop, but none of them have actually got there yet. And Home Assistant has actually included drag and drop, if you didn't know, in a few different menu options, so you can use it to actually reorganize things in your automations. The reason that drag and drop is a highly requested feature within the community is just because it's a very simple and very easy option to have, where you can just design these dashboards and just move things around, and it just makes everything very WYSIWYG. And if you're unsure of what I actually mean when I mention drag and drop, what I'm actually referring to is the ability to design and create your dashboards by actually just moving the cards or entities around. So you'll be able to drag them across the screen and then drop them in another location, and they'll just sit and move around in those orientations and placements. And as I mentioned, Home Assistant have teased this one a little bit, so fingers crossed that this one will actually appear this year.
Drag and drop, yes, it's coming.
Carrying on with my second feature then, and this one's another one that's highly requested within the community, and it's folders for automations. Currently, if you're designing and creating all of your automations within Home Assistant, you may end up with just a massive list of automations, and this list you have to scroll through or you have to filter it in a set way. So you can currently filter it by an area or by device or even by an entity. And having that ability to filter is nice, but it doesn't necessarily make it visually appealing or easy to actually identify where your sections or where your automations are actually contained. So a feature that I would love to see is the ability to actually create individual folders for these automations, and then you can drill down into those folders and find a particular automation that you're looking for. And I know not everyone will agree with folders or necessarily want them, but another option here instead of folders is maybe you could have some form of label or some kind of tag, and then you could view that tag or label as a top level header, and you could just filter them by this particular tag. For me personally, it's something that I'd want as a massive visual aid. Rather than just having this big massive list of all these automations, it would just help me find things a lot quicker. Up next, we've got my third feature, which tags on to Home Assistant's topic of the year, which is of course the year of the voice. And this feature is the ability to quickly add entities and devices to a voice assistant. As it is currently, if you want to expose a particular device or entity or some other part of your Home Assistant to your voice assistant, whether that be your Amazon Echo or your Google Assistant, you have to manually go into that section in Home Assistant. You then have to find the device and you then have to expose it. My proposal for a brand new feature would be the ability to actually just select the device or entity or script, whatever it is in Home Assistant, and just select it and then have the ability to expose it to whichever voice assistant you have set up. So if you have the Amazon Echo set up, you'd see a little Echo button, or if you've got the Google Assistant, or if you have both, you'll see buttons on that screen that you can just select to quickly expose that device. And this will just save you having to drill down into that menu and just select it there. Carrying on then, we've got my fourth feature, and this one is user-defined dashboards. Essentially, what this feature would allow you to do is it would allow you to design and create dashboards for specific users, and only those users that are assigned that dashboard can actually view and use those. The main purpose for this one would be for setting up wall panels, or maybe if you've got kids, setting up specific dashboards on their devices that only they can use, and that would stop them accessing parts of Home Assistant or turning things off in your office when they're not supposed to. Currently, it's only possible to do these things if you're making use of additional add-ons from hacks or adding things manually to your Home Assistant, so it would be nice to see this become a native feature and something that's expanded on. That way you can just customize your Home Assistant and you can actually make it a bit more secure by only allowing set people, set views and set access. And finally then, onto my fifth and final feature, And this one expands on a lot of the work that was done last year with Bluetooth, but it would be the ability to actually play audio using Bluetooth. I'm not quite sure how difficult this feature would actually be to implement, but the main idea here is you'd be able to connect your Home Assistant to a Bluetooth speaker, whether that's directly through a dongle or inbuilt Bluetooth, or maybe even one of the new Bluetooth proxies. But you'd connect Home Assistant to a Bluetooth speaker, and then you could just send audio to it, whether that's the form of music or text-to-speech. That'd be what I'd want with this feature. Over Christmas, I did a live stream with Franck, and I'm sure he actually mentioned that it is currently possible to do this, and there is a little workaround to do it.
I've done it before, actually, for myself. So you can pair. It's all via the command line. So you could go into the SSH add-on on the command line and then try to pair a Bluetooth audio device. Technically, that works. There's no UI for it.
Yeah, if you know them commands, it works.
Yeah.
So again, if it is possible, it would be nice to see this become a native feature with Home Assistant and just expand upon all of that Bluetooth work. I've got lots of cool Bluetooth speakers and I'd love to implement them just for text-to-speech devices or being able to play music across any of them. And there we go, guys. That's been 5 new features that I'd love to see added to Home Assistant in 2023. If there's a particular feature that you really liked, or there's a feature that maybe you'd want to see added yourself, then let me know what it is in the comments below. And while you're down there, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to drop me a like, and if you're not already, hit that subscribe button and ding-dong the notification bell. You'll then be alerted to any future video that I do. As always, a massive thank you to these awesome dudes. These awesome dudes are my Patreons, and if you're interested in helping support my channel, which in turn allows me to create content like this, then you'll find a link to my Patreon in the description below. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.